5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
I saw this illumination that was moving with respect to the stars. We were smart enough to not say, Houston, there's a light out there that's following us. So technically, it becomes an unidentified flying object.
While Neil and Buzz were on the lunar surface, Neil switched to the medical channel and spoke directly with the chief medical officer, saying, they're here, they're parked on the side of the crater, they're watching us. During the lunar mission, while Neil and Buzz were on the lunar surface, back at the Johnson Space Center, during a couple of minutes of broken communication, Neil switched over to the medical channel to speak directly with the chief medical officer of the mission. And at that, the comment was, he says, they're here, they're parked around the rim of the crater, and they're watching us. The command module is coming around the backside of the moon with the cameras rolling, and there's like a cluster of 5 little domes with light shining inside, and there was one of them that there was looked like a column of steam or something projected up from the top. So there was something really there. I can guarantee you it was certainly something that was not a natural occurrence on the moon.
But when the footage was played again the next day for NASA engineers, the key section with the mysterious domes had somehow disappeared.
I took the film out, and there was no splices, there were no cuts, and all the holes lined up. That means within 24 hours, they had to have taken the film out, cut the portion out, made a copy, airbrushed it out, spliced it back in, and then made a duplicate of it and had it available for it.
I suspect they're looking at us. They're busy, have been busy studying us. That's true. I have no doubt that extraterrestrials could very well have populated or made structures on the far side of the moon.
Aldrin finds it interesting that a scientist has come forward supporting the notion this could be artificial.
It surprised me that an extremely credible person, a professor, who is part of professional societies in the subject of settlements and colonization, he's aware of this, and he says, absolutely, without a doubt, it is not a natural formation. He didn't know anything other than that, but he just says it's just not.
We were aware there was a possibility of an unknown presence, possibly alien, extraterrestrial, near the Earth. There I am sitting in this room full of retired Army and Air Force generals and a few admirals, and we're watching what looks like a firefight in space. The most senior general there, an Army general, turned to me and said, where do you think they're from? And I said, I don't know, sir. I've heard they're from 40 light years from here. And his comment was, long supply lines. When an Army general says long supply lines, he's already thinking of, how do I deal with these people from far away? How do I make them go back to where they came from? The reaction of numerous space defense officials who I watched these movies with was fear and astonishment.